Okay, legendary students, ionic hydrides. Ionic hydrides means they form ionic bond. Here, hydrogen atom. Hydrogen atom and metals like first A group elements like sodium, lost one electron. Sodium metal is lost one electron. To forms Na plus and hydrogen atom accepting one electron to forms H minus. This Na plus plus H minus having electrostatic attractive forces are present. Then they forms NaH. This NaH is ionic hydride. This NaH is a ionic hydride. Okay, students. So ionic hydride means first A and second A group elements. First A and second A group elements donates electrons to the hydrogen atom. Then the hydrogen atom is existing H minus form and forms compounds. Those compounds are called as ionic hydrides. Okay, last class only we are discussing. In this ionic hydrides, this hydrogen atom oxidation state is equals to minus one. Hydrogen atom oxidation state is equals to minus one. Now, these ionic hydrides, their thermal stability order we need to discuss. Stability order. Ionic hydrides thermal stability decreases down the group. Thermal stability decreases down the group and reactivity increases. For example, first A group elements, hydrides stability order. What I said, the dear students, the thermal stability is decreases down the group. That's why lithium hydride is more stable than sodium hydride, lithium sodium, potassium hydride, rubidium, and then cesium hydride. The thermal stability is decreases down the group. And then cesium hydride decreases down the group. Okay, so thermal stability like second A group elements, hydrides, thermal stability. Second A group elements means what are, dear students? Beryllium hydride, magnesium hydride, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, and barium hydride. This barium hydride thermal stability decreases down the group and reactivity increases. It is very, very important. At the same way, reducing nature, these ionic hydrides acts as a good reducing agents. Good reducing agents. And reducing nature increases and reducing nature increases down the group. Increases down the group. Reducing nature, what happens, dear students? Reducing nature increases down the group. For example, reducing nature. Let's see reducing nature order. Reducing nature order. Reducing nature increases down the group, I said. Means lithium hydride and then sodium hydride, lithium sodium, potassium. Rubidium hydride and then cesium hydride. Reducing nature increases down the group. And the same way, second year group elements, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, and the barium hydride. These hydrides reducing nature increases down the group and thermal stability decreases down the group and reactivity also increases. Okay, students? Very, very important. Next, important point is these hydrides when reaction with water forms hydroxides. These hydrides reaction with water forms hydroxides. For example, sodium hydride reaction with water forms NaOH, forms NaOH, sodium hydride, sodium hydroxide will forms NaOH and liberates hydrogen gas and liberates hydrogen gas. Means these hydrides having alkaline nature, having a basic nature. Basic nature, and this basic nature also increases down the group. Basic nature increases down the group. Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, and cesium hydroxide is more basic nature when compared to lithium hydroxide. Basic nature increases down the group, and these hydrides, whenever these hydrides reaction with the water and forms hydroxides. Similarly, for example, magnesium is there. Magnesium hydride. Reaction with water forms MgOH twice. MgOH twice. Magnesium hydroxide. So here you have to use 2 moles of water, then OH twice. Total here 2 and 4 plus 1, 5. And liberates hydrogen gas. Then if you want to balance this equation, you have to take 2 moles, then 2 moles of MgOH twice, then you need to take 4. Here eight plus 2, 10 men. Already here 2, 4 is over and 6, 3 moles of H2 will liberate. Okay, students. So these ionic hydrides, like first A group element hydrides or second A group element hydrides, reaction with water to forms hydroxides and liberate hydrogen gas. These hydroxides are forming means what is the nature of these hydroxides? Basic nature. Base. This basic nature increases down the group. This basic nature increases down the group. Okay, students. This is about ionic hydrides. Ionic hydrides are acts as good reducing agents, and reducing nature or reducing strength increases down the group. Reducing strength increases down the group. And one more important thing is, lithium hydride as well as sodium hydrides are useful to preparation of good reducing agents. For example, this lithium hydride reaction with aluminium trichloride AlCl3 to forms lithium aluminium hydride will forms AlCl3. See here 4 hydrogen atoms are present. Then you have to take 4 moles of lithium hydride, then 3 moles of lithium chloride. This lithium aluminium hydride is a good reducing agent. Is a good reducing agent. Lithium aluminium hydride. Already this reagent we are used. This lithium aluminium hydride. Alkyl halides treated with lithium aluminium hydride and forms RH alkanes. It reduces alkyl halides into alkanes. Okay, students. And lithium aluminium hydride is a good reducing agent. Reduces aldehydes into alcohols. Aldehydes into alcohols. Or acids into alcohols. Carboxylic acids into alcohols. So this lithium aluminium hydride is a powerful reducing agent. This lithium aluminium hydride we are used in so many chemical reactions for reduction of different functional groups into corresponding products. So lithium aluminium hydride, how we are preparing, dear students? This lithium aluminium hydride is prepared when lithium hydride reacts with aluminium trichloride AlCl3 forms lithium aluminium hydride. And another important good reducing agent is another one more important good reducing agent is sodium borohydride. Sodium borohydride, NaBH4. This sodium borohydride, how we can prepare this sodium borohydride? Sodium hydride reaction with diboron, B2H6. Sodium hydride reaction with the diboron, B2H6. Then here two boron atoms are present in the product set 2, you have to write. Then total 4 to the 8 hydrogen atoms are present on product set here, 6 are present. And here 2 moles you have to take. 2 moles of NaH reacts with B2H6, forms 2 moles of NaBH4. 2 moles of NaBH4, sodium borohydride. Sodium borohydride, it is also good reducing agent. Compared to that, sodium borohydride is less reactive when compared with lithium aluminium hydride. Lithium aluminium hydride is a strong reducing agent. Strong when compared to sodium borohydride. This is importance about ionic hydrides. Okay, students. Listen, the second one is covalent hydrides. Covalent hydrides. Covalent hydrides. Covalent hydrides means they have covalent bonds are present. Means non-metals like a p-block elements, mostly 13th to 17th group elements. 13th to 17th group elements combine combined with hydrogen forms covalent hydrides. So CH means covalent hydrides. Okay, 13th to 17th group elements. These they are forming covalent hydrides. Again, these covalent hydrides are three types. These are three types. What are the different types of covalent hydrides? Let's see. The first one is electron deficient hydrides. Electron deficient hydrides. These electron deficient hydrides are formed by 13th group elements. 13th or 3rd A group. 13th or 3rd A group elements forms electron deficient hydrides. This general representation is MH3. The general representation is MH3, where M is equal to 3rd A group. example BH3, or actually the BH3 is exist in dimeric form B2H6, borane. Okay, diborane, its name is diborane or borane, BH3. ALH3, aluminium hydride, like this, where M is equals to third A group elements: boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium. Once you observe that BH3, the boron is the central atom. They having three electrons are present. The three electrons are involving bonding with three hydrogen atoms. So at the central atom, total 3 2s are 6 electrons are present. Means less number of electrons are present when compared to. They means they are not following octet rule. They are deficient molecules. Means in which central atom having less number of electrons required for bond formation. So central atom like having less number of electrons means already one vacant orbital is present, means they are electron deficient molecules. Okay, so central atom having less number of electrons present required than bond formation. Required than bond formation means central atom has 6 electrons are present. Means they are not following octet rule. They are not following octet rule and deficient molecules. Electron deficient molecule means they act as a Lewis acids. Acts as a Lewis acids and Lewis acidic strength decreases down the group and Lewis acidic strength. Decreases down the group. Lewis acidic strength decreases down the group because they are electron deficient. That's why these hydrides are called electron deficient hydrides. Electron deficient hydride. They act as a Lewis acids and Lewis acidic strength decreases down the group and they form D2 bonds. Forms D2 bond. This is information about electron deficient hydrides. Let's listen, dear students. In peacock elements, 13th to 17th group elements forms covalent hydrides. Again, that covalent hydride they divided into three types. One is electron deficient hydrides. Second one is precious. Third one is electron rich hydrides. Okay, like three types of hydrides are present. In that one type is electron deficient hydrides. The electron deficient hydrides are mainly formed by the 13th group elements or third A group elements. Third A group elements means boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium, in which central atom has less number of electrons than required bond formation. That's why less number of electrons are present means they act as the Lewis acids and deficient, and Lewis acidic strength decreases down the group. Lewis acidic strength decreases down the group. So they have one vacant orbital is present, means they ready to form D2 bond. They ready to form a D2 bond. Okay, student, this is about electron deficient hydrides. Now let's see second one, electron precious hydrides. Electron precious hydrides. Electron precious hydrides. Electron precious hydrides means the central atom. Means central atom has sufficient number of electrons involving bonding. Means the central atom containing all valence electrons involving in bonding. involving in bonding. So mainly 14th or 4th A group elements, 14th or 4th A group elements, 14th or 4th A group elements forms electron precise hydrides. So examples, CH4 silicon, carbon silicon germanium hydrides. Carbon silicon germanium, this general representation is MH4. The general representation is MH4. Okay students, now these are neutral hydrides. Neutral hydrides, and their neutral hydrides and thermal stability decreases down the group. Means CH4 is more stable than SiH4, and then germanium hydride, and then tin and lead hydrides. Like, okay students, so this is about electron precise hydrides generally formed by the 14th group elements or 4th A group elements, in which central atom has how many electrons? Central atom has 4 electrons are present. Valence shell contains 4 electrons are present. Those all 4 electrons are involving in bonding. These all 4 electrons are involving in bonding. That's why these are acts as a neutral hydrides. The nature of electron precise hydrides nature is neutral hydrides. Okay students, next third one is electron rich hydrides. The third one is electron rich hydrides. Electron rich hydrides. Electron rich hydride means central atom contains more number of electrons. Central atom has more valence electrons than required, more valence electrons than required for bond formation, that required for a bond formation. Such type of p block elements forms electron rich hydrides. These electron rich hydrides formed by 15th group, 16th group and 17th group elements. 15th group elements, the general representation is MH3, and 16th group general representation is MH2, and 17th group element, the general representation of the hydrides is MH. And this 15th group element hydrides are basic nature. And this basic nature decreases down the group. Basic nature decreases down the group. For example, NH3, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth. Bismuth hydrides. These are the 15th group element hydrides. These 15th group element hydrides nature is basic nature. The basic nature is decreases down the group. Means ammonia is more basic than PH3 because the central atom contains one lone pair electron is present. Means the central atom has 5 electrons are present. Out of the 5 electrons, all electrons, means central atom contains more valence electrons than required for bond formation, than required for bond formation. Means 3 only involving bonding, one lone pair is present. Then that lone pair is donating nature. If it is lone pair donor, means it is a Lewis base. They act as a Lewis bases. So the Lewis basic nature decreases down the group for 15th group elements. And 16th group element hydrides also electron rich hydrides, and 17th group element hydrides also electron rich hydrides. The general formula is MH2 and MH. Now these 16th group element hydrides are acidic nature, and this is also acidic nature. And this acidic nature increases down the group. Why means? Because bond dissociation energy is decreases. And acidic nature increases down the group because bond dissociation energy decreases. Now example, this acidic strength order, 16th group, oxygen H2O, H2S, oxygen sulfur, cellurium hydride and tellurium hydride. There is acidic nature increases down the group. And the 17th group element hydrides, HF, HCl, HBr and HI. Their acidic nature also increases down the group. These acidic natures and basic natures are very, very important for JNE examination. This is about electron-rich hydrides. So covalent hydrides are three types. One is deficient, the second one is precious, and third one is electron-rich hydrides. Okay, students. So next, the third type of hydrides are interstitial hydrides. Third type of hydrides are interstitial hydrides. Interstitial hydrides means what is the meaning of interstitial? Interstitial means the hydrogen atoms are internally trapped or holded in some of the metal atoms. The type of hydrides are called as interstitial hydrides. These type of hydrides are formed by D and F block elements. F block elements forms. D and F block elements forms interstitial hydrides. Okay, why D and F block elements only forms interstitial hydrides means because D and F block elements means these are the metals. Metals in their crystalline structures, they have some interstitial holes or interstitial places or sites are present. In that vacant places, the hydrogen atoms are trapped. Means transition elements, means D block elements and inner transition elements, F block elements. D and F block elements existing in three-dimensional crystal structure, in their crystal lattice structures. D and F block metals in their crystalline structure having holes. These holes are occupied by, it was occupied by hydrogen atoms called as interstitial hydrides. Okay, so D and F block elements like scandium in its crystalline structure or in crystal lattice structure. Scandium in its crystal lattice structure having some holes are present. That hole will be occupied. For example, you have to imagine that it is one crystal lattice, crystalline structure, this box completely. So internally some hole, small hole is present, like see this is the hole. Here some hole is present. That hole will be, this chalk, maybe you have to think as hydrogen atoms. In that crystalline structure, actually metal atoms are present in three-dimensional crystal lattice structures are present. In that crystal lattice structures, while the atoms are present in close packing structure, due to that close packing structure having some small holes or gaps are present. That hole is called interstitial hole or interstitial sites. In that interstitial sites, the small hydrogen atoms are will be trapped or present. Such type of compounds are called as interstitial hydrides. Example, scandium hydride, lanthanum hydride, yttrium hydride, like These are called interstitial hydrides. So these interstitial hydrides, what are the properties of metals are present? Those all properties also be present for interstitial hydrides. When compared to that metal, interstitial hydrides are more stable and chemically less reactive. And conductivity is retains same. And melting and boiling points will be increases. That is the main important properties of interstitial hydrides. Okay, students, this is about types of hydrides. Hydrides are mainly how many types? Three types. What are those three types, dear students? Ionic hydrides, covalent hydrides. Third one is interstitial hydrides. Ionic hydrides will be formed by first and second group elements. Next, covalent hydrides are formed by 13th to 17th group. Again, the covalent hydrides are three types. What are those? Electron deficient hydrides, electron precious hydrides, and electron rich hydrides. These electron deficient hydrides are Lewis acidic nature is present. Electron precious hydrides are neutral nature is present. Electron rich hydrides having 15th group element hydrides are basic nature, 17th group element hydrides are acidic nature, and 16th group element hydrides also